Now, when we're teaching children and we're thinking about our children, most parents that I talk to, without even realizing it, have a theory in their head that I like to call the pristine statue. And they want to protect their children. I know parents that will do first grade homework. I know parents that will do second grade homework, third grade homework, fourth grade homework, and then they're done, they can't do fifth grade homework. And the kids are in deep trouble by then. Because we all want our children to succeed. How many of you want your children to succeed? We do not want them to fail. How many of you want your children to fail? I didn't see one hand. When I get through with you, you're going to change your attitude. I call this theory of wanting our children to succeed and not wanting them to fail, I call it the pristine statue theory. Do you see those pretty little pristine fingers? What happens if one of those fingers gets broken? Does it diminish the value of the statue? If you have a beautiful pristine porcelain statue, if that finger gets broken, does it diminish its value? Will you keep it? Probably if it's just a finger. Right? But what if somebody comes along and they knock it over and it breaks off the whole arm? Are you going to keep it then? No, you're going to toss it out. Well, this is kind of how we're raising our children. Oh my gosh, don't fail. You know, and if you fail once, then you've broken a finger. But children get really afraid of failing. Now, what I want you to think about, instead of the pristine statue theory, let's think of the Michelangelo block of marble theory. This is what I used to tell my son when he would go to school. I would say, how are you going to fail today? You better come home and tell me a really great way you failed. Because if you didn't fail, you're not trying hard enough. You're not risking enough. Because it is truly through our failures that we learn to succeed. And every failure that we have strengthens us. I used to say, you've got to be Thomas Edison. That man really knows how to succeed because he failed so many times getting there. That's what we're like. When you think of Michelangelo, they would bring this huge block of marble into his room, and he would say, there's greatness in that block of marble. And he would go to hammering and chipping and chiseling and sanding and sawing. And with every chip and with everything that he would take away, what was left was greatness. And I would tell my children that that's how I want you to think about life. Every failure, every time you fall down, every time you make a wrong turn, every time you do something wrong, think of Michelangelo hitting that block of marble and you're getting to your greatness. Now, if we taught children to fail, how much more would they learn? Remember that book that I talked to you about earlier, Nurture Shock? Yeah, it's surprising I'm promoting somebody else's book other than mine. But this book talks about the studies that they have done, that if you go in and you tell a child, very bright children, and you tell them that they're very bright, they don't try as hard because they're so scared. But if you tell children that, wow, you didn't do great, you got like medium high, but boy, you tried hard. It really looks like you tried hard. The next time they try harder. Isn't it interesting? That's how our minds work. We don't want to fail. So if we get set up in the pristine statue place, then we're sort of stuck. We want our children to fail.